Many of you have had a serious challenge in terms of Dominica, in terms of Hurricane Maria. Those of you who experienced Hurricane Maria, those of us who live in Dominica more than likely, and those of us who at my age or younger are going to experience another one at some point in our lives. So some of you may not have to do that. But I really want to say thank you very much to all of you who have actually come back to Dominica. And as Dr. Clayton Schillingford said, you make a major impact on the country in terms of the economic activity. You live in Dominica, you study in Dominica, you party in Dominica at times, hopefully World Caribbean Music Festival. And actually, I'm the Minister of Tourism and Culture, so I'll always try to plug some of these in. We have Carnival coming up, but obviously you have to do your best to manage your study time and your party time. They always say that when you work hard, you have to play a little bit. But you being here really makes a big input in terms of the rental of properties, and the landlords definitely need those funds. You eat, and I'm sure that you go to the market and buy a lot of our fresh produce. I know quite a bit of you also import your own food because you have particular delicacies that you like, and the country also makes earns revenue from the duties and all these things. So you being here makes a huge difference. The many people who are employed at this university, as the professors, the persons, the janitors, the persons fixing the AC units, and to name a few. So we really appreciate you being here, and we know that it's not gonna be easy. In terms of life is never easy. There's many challenges, but the important thing is to learn from those challenges and continue to push on. I come from the private sector, so I'd like to maybe take a little different slant in terms of saying something to you. Many times our parents tell us to go to school and get great grades. Then they tell us to go to university and get good grades. And traditionally they tell us to, when we're finished, either become a doctor or a lawyer, because traditionally these are the jobs that make a significant amount of money. But because I come from the business sector, I like to put a challenge to you. You being doctors, it means you're gonna be what I consider to be in the S class. S class meaning self-employed. It's great to be self-employed, but there's one setback to being self-employed most times. If you're sick, you're not earning an income. So I'd like to challenge you, when you do become doctors, try to take it to the next level. Try to have your own hospital, your own clinic. Don't just stay where many people expect you to be. Take it to the next level. Have your own clinic where you can actually employ persons and have persons working for you. Which means if your true passion is to impact on people's lives, you can do even more. And if you are financially free, it means you can actually have your own clinics. You can come back to Dominica at some point in time and do free clinics in here whilst your clinic somewhere in the world is still continuing to operate. So I say to you, push yourself a little bit more. At the age of 35, I had a great family. But at the same time, I was like doing like everybody else. I was spending all my money. And I had an accident. I'm not Superman, but I flew 90 feet. Luckily, I'm alive. And there's these two books that I read. The Richest Man in Babylon. It's a very small book. I hated to read, so I think my mom gave me that book on purpose because she knew I'd actually read it. And there's another book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad. It helped to change my mindset in terms of education and also financial education. So financial education is key. So you can stay being an employee, but you have to make sure that you save your money properly so that you can retire. Many of us don't think of retirement. So even you right now, many of you, I don't think have even considered what retirement is. But at some point in your life, you have to retire. And at some point in your life, when you retire, you're going to live maybe, 30 years? Now just imagine how much money you have to have saved up for that. So start planning for your retirement from now. It'll make a huge difference in your life. Do like Mr. Clayton Schillingford. He has obviously done his financial planning very well. So he can afford to fly to Dominica every now and then and relax, and then go back to the States when he can. So follow in his footsteps to make a huge difference. But again, I just want to say on behalf of the Minister of Education, we truly appreciate your support. We truly appreciate you as students being here. We appreciate the lecturers. I'm sure your task isn't very easy, You have your own issues, you have your roofs to cover, you have all sorts of issues, but you still have to come here and face students who, some of them might be giving you certain attitudes, and then you still have to give them the best possible experience without losing it. So again, thank you very much for that. Thank you to the faculty for having confidence in Dominica, because you could have chosen not to come back to Dominica. And that would have been another huge impact on the economy and all the people of Dominica. So we truly say thank you very much for coming back to Dominica, having the trust in Dominica. A lot of work is being done, a lot of work has been done, and there's still a lot more to be done. But the government of Dominica is fully committed to doing that work to push the country forward in the best interest of all of the people. So again, thank you very much, and I wish you all the best and success in your life. And hopefully in 5 or 10 years' time, if I come back to this event, one of you guys will be here talking about your life experience and how you've done well and how you've impacted so many other people. So again, thank you.